So what exactly is additive manufacturing? Well, there are many different additive manufacturing processes, but perhaps the most familiar picture is that of a desktop 3D printer, building an object by extruding beads of plastic layer by layer. Formally, we can define additive manufacturing as a process by which digital 3D design data is used to build up a component in layers by depositing material. The term 3D printing is increasingly used as a synonym for additive manufacturing, for AM, but the latter is more accurate because we're now thinking about professional production techniques that are clearly distinguished from conventional methods of material removal. Consider machining, a subtractive process of material removal, where to make any part you must start with a larger workpiece. You generate waste, which has very little value relative to the raw material, and in many cases also cooling fluid contaminated with chips from the machine. Or molding or casting, what we call formative processes, where you can make parts in incredible quantities, in some cases millions or more, but you need to have expensive tooling, which takes a lot of time and money in terms of investment before you make even one part. Now, additive manufacturing is in some ways the opposite. You build up your part layer by layer directly from digital data. And we must appreciate that even the most simple 3D printing process has many steps and also important design constraints. However, the fact that you can make a part from a digital file, the material, the right 3D printer, and the printing instructions is incredibly enabling to think differently from the start. More broadly, here are a few reasons why we want to use additive manufacturing. Obviously, at the start it can enable fast prototyping in your office or in your machine shop. But also it can achieve complex geometries, many of which we couldn't imagine before. We can also design parts for enhanced performance, for instance greater strength or reduced weight, or embedding thermal management features such as internal cooling channels and heat exchangers in mold tooling and in other devices. Using AM, we can also think about consolidating assemblies into fewer parts. That's because a lot of assemblies are so because we have to respect the constraints of existing manufacturing techniques. Therefore, by 3D printing, we can consolidate several parts into one and save a lot of cost and time. With 3D printing, we can also design parts to be made of multiple materials, and we're starting to design materials directly for additive manufacturing. We can also envision viable production at low volumes. At a limit, individual personalization, unique parts in a quantity of one, but also intermediate volumes to, for instance, more confidently test markets or differentiate our products for specific markets and specific groups of customers. And in the broad sense, AM suggests we can improve the efficiency of supply chains by reducing inventory via on-demand production, and that's especially valuable for time-critical spare parts. These applications and business models really span across the product lifecycle, from concept to end of life. And meaningfully, the use of additive manufacturing in mass production will enable designers and engineers to envision its use from the start of the design process and use it throughout that product lifecycle.